Rolling, I saw rolling hills and valleys and places where our pets go. Animals, you know, they run free, they roam free. Horses and cows and ducks and all of them, you know, anything. And then I heard this music that was the most magnificent music I've ever heard in my life. The leaves on the trees have a vibration. Each blade of grass has a vibration. The rocks that were in the stream that sparkled like diamonds, the water has a vibration, the rock has a vibration, the animals. Everything has its own vibration, even the colors. If you imagine the colors of a rainbow, each color has its own vibration, so a rainbow is not just a rainbow that's pretty to look at, but it's also a vibration. You can hear a rainbow if you, you know, because each color has its own sound. So when you take all of those individual sounds and you put them together, it was the most magnificent orchestra and choir I've ever heard. And everything was singing praises to God. It was just amazing. What I've told people this before that have written to me or called me, and they don't feel that God loves them or they feel alone or whatever. And I said, stop, think about this for a second. God loves you as if you were the only one he ever created. And he loves you so much that he thinks about you every single second of every single day. And if he stopped thinking about you, you would just poof, you would cease to exist as if you never were. So you know that he loves you so much. Like I said, as if you were the only one. And he loves each one of us as if we were the only one he ever created. There is a beautiful life after this life. And the things that are happening in this world, the horrors that you're talking about, that happens because of people's selfishness. You know, God gives us free will. He's a gentleman. He's not going to step in and say, wait a second. That's this person's sacred space. Don't go in there. You stay over here in your little corner. You know, he doesn't do that. We have to learn as humankind, as people, that we are here to learn how to love and be loved. And there are many kinds of love, but that the kind of love that we are here to learn how to do is the agape love. It's the way that God loves us, unconditionally, no strings attached. You don't have to earn it. You don't have to do anything to get it. He just loves you. He likes you and he loves you, period. And you don't have to do anything for it. Having said that, there are people out there who don't honor other people's sacred space and they're selfish and they want what they want. And so they're going to impose their free will onto someone else. And that's how a lot of children get hurt. People get raped. People get murdered. You know, it's selfishness, pure and simple. The opposite of love is not hate. It's selfishness. And hatred is born out of selfishness.